We as men are curious. This is why we dare to explore. The key element of exploration is finding the interesting things. Therefore, we build overlook points like this or satellites observing the Earth or other planets. However, accessing the data is challenging for big satellites and CubeSats alike, because we have to know where they are. I believe we can bring tracking and communication with space to the internet for the benefit of all. We are building a distributed ground station network, a global grid of small ground stations connected to the internet that allows the permanent reception of satellite beacon signals. The catch is that we are bringing it to everyone by using standard GPS receivers and the citizen science approach. I will explain how we do that. Lots of ground stations will be deployed in back gardens and on balconies and plugged to the internet. When a satellite comes into reach of 5 or more stations, the network is able to trilaterate the position and track its path by correlating the beacon signal event with the GPS synced time. In one sentence, think of it as a reverse GPS. In the end, the data is sent via the internet to our server and to the set operator. Now you might ask, why do we work on such a tracking network? It's simple. We want to help CubeSat operators and the spaceflight community. Furthermore, we want to make the general public be more involved in space. CubeSat operators face the problem that their satellites are sometimes not delivered into the specified orbit. Due to small variations in the orbit parameters, their ground stations have difficulties in making connections. We can help providing corrected orbit parameters faster and receiving and forwarding telemetry data to them. By this, the distributed ground station network is increasing safety and help avoiding collisions and thus space debris. Moreover, we are fostering collaborations and operations due to the shared network. And we are directly involved people in not only demonstrating the necessity of space applications, but we can also deliver essential emergency data such as weather forecasts and flooding trends and other locally needed data. Daylight. Before we are tracking satellites, I already invite you to participate. We are currently in prototype development and you can join our community for the test phase. It includes ground measurements as well as tracking of air vehicles such as quadrocopters and high altitude balloons and rockets. In the end, we all shall benefit by the distributed ground station network. Just imagine you will be a space tourist someday and you will board one of her successors. Wouldn't it be great if you could send messages and pictures to your friends and family at home directly? Use the distributed ground station network.